all began with sampling some local oysters at a Carteret Wild-Caught Seafood Festival. The oysters were courtesy of Dr. Niels Lindquist, a UNC PhD, and David Clammerhead Cessna, a longtime area oysterman.
This one I personally will like better. I already know because it's more salty and I prefer the saltier oysters. This one's from the sandbar out in the middle of the mouth of the Newport River. That's a good oyster.
That's a very good oyster. A good finish on them.
These are delicious.
And it's still tasting good.
You're really doing wild oysters in a managed way. You can get spat or baby oysters from the hatchery and grow them that way, which some people are doing.
That's right.
And you can capture the seed right there on the site out of the water and have it attached to your material.
Exactly. So we're dealing with the oysters from the wild native population.
Well, that was enough to get me onto a boat for a closer look. I found just over an acre of oysters in all stages of development on an intertidal sandbar very near the salty inflow of Beaufort Inlet. An application to expand the lease of this public river bottom to over 6 acres is in the works. With the oysters exposed at low tide and covered at high tide, it's an ideal oyster breeding ground during the summer spawning season.
Well, these are frames holding a material we call oyster catcher. It's a new substrate that Clammerhead and I invented. So it's a plant-based fiber cloth like burlap and jute that we infuse with cements.
The oyster larvae in the water attach prolifically to this material and become coin-sized seed oysters.
You started with panels like this, and you ended up with small oysters that you took off these, you broke them off, and you put them in bags.
That's right.
What we're seeing in these bags are oyster seed that have been taken off of the oyster catcher material, where we will either sell them to other growers to grow out for the half shell market, or we will grow them out for the half shell market ourselves.
Yeah, okay.
Preferably as the Atlantic Emerald.
The Atlantic Emerald will be the pair's version of a special gourmet type oyster with unique coloring and complex flavor that's prized in France. But while that may be a lucrative niche market, the pair's biggest future business could be in restoring shoreline to a cleaner, more productive state through establishing reefs of natural clusters of oysters, not singles.
We have these structures that we build out of our substrate that can be built to withstand a bit of impact and wave action. When those harden in place with the oyster larvae attached to them, the spat grow out. They end up making a good base for living shorelines or restoration projects in a lot of different areas where standard methods just do not work.
Using leftover materials, the partners even developed these oyster patties. Wild baby oysters in larva form attached to their substrate to quickly form oyster reefs in miniature, if you will.
It allows you to get an oyster reef and then to get further production from grasses and so forth, which helps that get established.
People place a lot of value on the salt marsh grasses and the sea grasses and the oyster reefs. Those are what they call the foundation species. So they build habitat, that three-dimensional structure that other animals live in and hide from or forage in.
But I am a foodie and an oyster eater above all. I'll be savoring those Atlantic emeralds down the road, and I'm grateful these guys plotted to tempt me into checking out what they're already putting on the plat.
Whatever you're doing, keep it up.
Thank you.
That is
terrific.
There's
delicious oysters out in those rivers.
Go, Louisiana, don't mean Mexico.